Hello, my friends. This is Reid. Welcome to a Legacy video here on ChannelFireball.com. Today I'm going to be playing Legacy Elves, complete with the banning of Deathrite Shaman. So new format, new stuff to explore, new card choices, but still a deck that I think could be great. I'm playing Elves largely by popular demand. I had a lot of comments in the comment section of my videos, and people contacting me on Twitter and mentioning it when I meet people at real life in tournaments, asking for a Legacy Elves video. So I just want to say that even though I can't always answer every request, keep making those requests because I am listening and I'm trying my best. And even if it doesn't come, you know, the week you request the video, I'm trying my best. So here by popular demand, Legacy Elves. Naturally, I have cut the four Deathrite Shamans. I replaced them with one Findhorn Elves, pretty natural replacement there. A second copy of Birchlore Rangers, which it's nice to be able to produce black mana when you're comboing after sideboarding, when you might bring in some discard spells or Abrupt Decays. One Reclamation Sage, which this is a card that probably should be in the deck anyway. Now that Mono Red Prison is very popular, just an out to Ensnaring Bridge makes it a lot easier to win the game once you've comboed off. Also, there are plenty of decks with Chalice of the Void and other miscellaneous stuff. And then one copy of Multani's Acolyte, which is sort of a secret sleeper type card that I always have liked for a long time. It's clearly worse than Elvish Visionary because of the Echo, but a lot of times the Echo won't matter. You can either just not pay it, or you can bounce it with a Wirewood Symbiote, or you'll have so much mana that it's trivial anyway. And this is just a fifth copy of Elvish Visionary, which is one of the cards that makes the deck function. So I'm going to give that a try. Sideboard, largely the same as I've been playing for a long time, but with some definite concessions to Reanimator in four Leyline of the Void. This is because Reanimator is traditionally one of the toughest matchups for Legacy Elves, and it's also one of the biggest winners from the banning of Deathrite Shaman. So certainly a deck that I'm expecting to face and that I'm going to need to do something special in order to beat. So this is the deck I'm playing for today. I hope you'll stay with me. Hello and welcome to match number one of this Legacy League. We're playing Elves. I get to be on the play, and my opening hand is not terribly exciting, but this is a totally functional hand that I can keep on the strength of Elvish Visionary. With this hand, all I need to do is draw a Glimpse of Nature, a Natural Order, a Wirewood Symbiote, a Green Sun Zenith, or another Elvish Visionary. Those are five different cards that I can draw to really get moving, and I'll have at least, you know, three fresh cards to have seen by turn three. So this is an average level hand, but one that I'm definitely happy to keep. I'm going to not lead on Windswept Heath because I can cash that in for a Dryad Arbor later on. I think just Heritage Druid is going to be a fine bet. Ah, mirror match. Well, it's really good that I won the die roll. But it's kind of not so good that my hand is uninspired. Well, I think this turn is going to be Bayou, Nettle Sentinel, Quirion Ranger, Visionary. See what happens. Oh, I meant to play Quirion Ranger. I don't think it really is a big deal which of the one drops I led on there. So Symbiote or Green Sun Zenith would be amazing here. Okay, well, I don't know if I have lethal on the board next turn. I'll have to figure that out, but I can cast the Crater Hoof next turn. And it looks like it won't be quite lethal with what I have, but if I draw something helpful like a Gaia's Cradle or Quarian Ranger or a Wirewood Symbiote that I might be able to make it lethal. It's close. Maybe I can make my opponent chump block with just the Nettle Sentinel and the Crater Hoof. It's going to be attacking for 19. All of this, of course, is contingent on living through the turn, which Elves doesn't combo on turn 2 terribly often, maybe like 15% of the time uncontested, but it could happen. A little bit harder now that my opponent's made their land drop and not played Gaia's Cradle. I'm just going to F6 here because, you know, there's no illusions that I could have Force of Will in my hand or anything like that. So, if I draw a blank, a land, I'm going to tap three Elves, two lands, that's five mana, then use the Quarian Ranger ability to untap an Elf, three more mana, that's eight, fetch a Dryad Arbor, cast the Crater Hoof Behemoth, then I'll have Nettle Sentinel and Crater Hoof to attack with, and they'll both have +7/+7, so that's going to be 21 damage trample, which my opponent will survive, assuming the Nettle Sentinels can block, but at least just making the opposing Elves player chump block and lose a couple creatures, that's pretty nice, and put myself in a position to maybe just win by attacking the old-fashioned way. And as I mentioned, there are plenty of draws that allow me to cast the Crater Hoof even easier. If I can attack with the third creature, winning should be trivial. Ooh, hello, Priest of Titania. It's one you don't see every day. Very powerful card. Kind of like a Gaia's Cradle on delay for one turn. Okay, let's see if my draw step is good to me. That is good. So, just think it out. Three mana, floating two, play Birch Lore, untap Nettle. Five mana, six, seven, just fetch a land. Eight, cast a Crater Hoof, untap Nettle. Quarian Ranger, still untapped. Yeah, this should be... we should be in the clear. So pump my dudes, now I'll use the Quarian ability to untap Visionary, and I get to attack with four creatures, which is very comfortably lethal. So to be honest, that's a really typical game in the Elves mirror. Elves is just overwhelmingly likely to win on exactly turn three, which makes the die roll really, really important. Now if you follow my Elves content here on Channel Fireball pretty regularly. You might remember I wrote an article where I touched on the Elves mirror and I said that over sideboarding is a big risk and I try not to change too many cards at all. So sometimes when I'm on the draw, I'll bring in like 1 to 3 thought seizes. I mean, clearly I have Reclamation Sage that should come out. Then Multani's Acolyte is not the best and can trim on the weaker of my elves. I actually do like the Visionaries, even though they're a little slow for a Goldfish type matchup. If either or both players wind up bringing in a lot of discard spells, then you want to have the Visionaries to make sure you don't, you know, make sure you can keep the action coming. But Multani's Acolyte's probably bad enough that I should cut it. So if I just cut Reclamation Sage and 2 other miscellaneous guys, bring in 3 Thought Seizes, that should be a nice, like, minimal sideboard change that gives me a prayer of being able to break serve if I can nab the right card with the Thought Seize. But for the most part, you just want to make sure you don't dilute your deck and can still win on turn 3 pretty often. Interesting hand. Think I should mulligan. So if I go Dryad Arbor, next turn Misty Rainforest, double Birchlore Rangers, that I can probably natural order on turn 3, but not really attack with that much. I think I can do better. Well, one forest makes this hand pretty strong with the Quirion Rangers. Like, for example, if I scry a forest at the top, I go Forest, Fintorn Elves. Next turn, if I brick on land, I can go Glimpse, Quirion Ranger, bounce the forest on top, Fintorn Elves, replay the forest, and I have 2 mana left, 2 more creatures. So this might be worth keeping and just hope I have a forest in my top 2 cards. Now there's 14 really good draws in the good lands, plus 2 Dryad Arbors, which I guess I could keep on top. Dryad Arbor is pretty bad. So if I have 14 cards that I like to see and 2 shots at it. It's like less than 1/3 of my deck. So I'm probably a little below 50-50 to find one, but a little below 50-50 to have a really good hand versus mulliganing to 5 is a pretty close call. Not sure what the right thing to do is here. If you have a strong opinion, definitely chime in on the comments, but I'm gonna take a mulligan. All right, well, this one I just have to keep now. Okay. Might be able to assemble like a turn 4 kill with this hand, but that's pretty unlikely to be a winning play in the mirror. I mean, if next turn is good to me, I could have a pretty explosive turn. Heritage Druid, Gaia's Cradle, Visionary, draw card, have 3 mana. Yeah, I mean, who knows? Maybe the Crater Hoof can come down on turn 3. So the fact that my opponent tapped the Cradle for that indicates to me that they have Abrupt Decay, like some kind of card that needs black mana. Interesting. Interesting. Well, I think I still need to go Heritage Druid Visionary, even though I drew the glimpse, just because I need some creatures in play for the cradle. I guessed it correctly. Okay, now no attack. Hopefully, I draw a creature for next turn and then get lucky with my glimpse. This looks like okay. Okay, well, only thing I can do this turn is play Dryad Arbor and pass. Hope my opponent does not have any action. More abrupt decays. Eight mana, that can't be a good sign. All right, GG, GG. See what I would have drawn next turn. Symbiote, that would have been a good draw. Could have definitely glimpsed off there. Okay, well, that was the game that was going to go the worst for me when I was on the draw and I mulled to five. Now, being back on the play. I still don't want the Reclamation Sage, but I'm going to cut two of the Thought Seizes, so only one Thought Seize in my deck, and I'm going to let being on the play and, giving the possibility of my opponent over sideboarding as my ways to gain an advantage here. Sure, this works. My opponent has mulliganed. And scry to the top. So, potentially, the way I'll play this hand is next turn I can just go Visionary and maybe fetch for another Arbor. It depends what I draw, though. Like, I want to set myself up for either a glimpse turn or a symbiote visionary combination, or maybe both. Okay, Quarian Ranger. So that's going to be really strong on a glimpse turn. Think the plan is I'm going to start with Elvish Visionary. Then if I draw another creature, I'll just Zenith for an Arbor. And if I draw like something that doesn't help with the glimpse, then maybe I'll save the Zenith for a symbiote. But I am going to start with the Visionary because that uses my mana pretty well. gives me more information. Okay, so now I found another Quarian Ranger. I'm gonna Zenith for Dryad Arbor just to give myself the most mana for next turn that I can possibly get. And I'll fetch because it's deck thinning and I no longer have any Dryad Arbors in my library after I do this. So I don't need the optionality for later. Okay, now I just hold my breath, hope my opponent doesn't turn to me with a good Guy's Cradle draw. Okay, I'm safe. So I could fetch, but I usually don't like to play. I like to wait as long as I can to play a land in case I draw into Guy's Cradle. So I'm going to value that a little higher than the deck thinning here. But I will start with Glimpse of Nature. And Quarian Ranger. Little Sentinel. Quarian Ranger. So now I'll just make my land drop. Grab a forest, play another Nettle Sentinel. That's an amazing draw. So I can keep the gas flowing a little bit longer by using the Quarian Ranger's abilities. So I'm going to bounce my forest, untap my Dryad Arbor, play the Symbiote, draw another card, but I really need to find either Heritage Druid or Birch Lore Rangers if I'm going to keep going off indefinitely. Okay, another Nettle. So I have one more Quarian Ranger activation. Actually, potentially two more because of the Symbiote. But I guess I'll just... play another Nettle Sentinel for my hand for now. Can still win the game this turn if I find Heritage Druid. Alright. So now I've already used both of these. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Symbiote to untap Dryad Arbor, bouncing a Quarian Ranger. Play a Ranger. Now I'll use the fresh Quarian Ranger, untap the Arbor again. So you can see, even without like fully comboing, I can keep the cards flowing for a pretty extended period of time. Oh, Birch Lore Rangers. Might be too late, we'll see. So the last thing I can do is I can return one Arbor to untap the other Arbor. Play the Birch Lore. Now I can actually generate mana with all my Nettle Sentinels. I've already made my land drop. I've already used all my creatures, but that one works, that symbiote. Think I can do it. So now I find Green Sun Zenith, which will definitely get me a Heritage Druid. Still, mana is my limiting factor at this point. Got a hand of six lands. And I found Natural Order. So my only creatures that can attack right now are a Dryad Arbor and a Visionary, but that should be enough. So not even going to waste my breath. Casting that Heritage Druid, just going to Natural Order, sacking this Quarian Ranger. And my opponent's seen enough. All right, so 1-0. And I'm back for match number two with Legacy Elves. I'm on the draw this time. With a functional hand. This is one that I'm going to keep because I can get a basic forest and a Findhorn Elves on turn one. But depending on whether or not my creature dies and whether or not I draw a second land, this could be either explosive or pretty slow and uninspired. So my opponent leads with Polluted Delta, doesn't really narrow it down too much yet. See what happens. Huh. All right, Grixis, Delverith, Bomat Courier. Well, that's a card that I'm very much not afraid of since I have tons and tons of cheap blockers. I think I'm still going to stick with the plan of Forest Findhorn Elves. No days is good news for me. I'm not going to block this turn, the Bomat Courier, but I might on a future turn. Okay, so I think I should go Nettle Sentinel, then Fetch for Forest, Heritage Druid. Maybe I should start with the Heritage Druid. And then tap three Visionary Symbiote, see if all that stuff works. I could even Reclamation Sage the Bomat Courier. That's a pretty nice play. All right, well, start with Heritage Druid. My opponent pressed F6. Not a great play for the Day's Force of Will deck. Yeah, I think Reclamation Sage is looking pretty nice. Alternatively, I could go Visionary Symbiote. No, it's not as good. It's a good bet that this deck's not going to have any better targets in game one for the Sage than Bomat Courier. Sure, Fatal Push Heritage Druid, that takes a little bit of the wind out of my sails, but should be okay. Well, I could just Natural Order. Sack the Fintorn Elf, get Crater Hoof, that'd be 9 plus 9, 18 damage. Nah, I'll wait on it. Start with Visionary. Guess I can attack with just Nettle Sentinel here. Now I will untap my Fintorn Elf with Visionary, fetch for sure, another forest. I don't have any black cards in my main deck. And yeah, set up for a really nice turn. Next turn, barring a board sweeper, and I can even beat, you know, Force of Will. My opponent just drew a Volcanic that turn. Makes sense after the Mist land drop and not flipping the Delver. Targeting the Symbiote, so I will bounce my Visionary, which is a play that I have to make just in case my opponent does have an answer for the Natural Order. I don't want to be left without any gas. Double Bolt. Sure. All right, Zenith. What does that do for me? So my first question is, can I navigate this turn in a way where I cast Natural Order and have both these creatures untapped? So I'm trying to think, like, if I Zenith for a Quirion Ranger, maybe that can do the trick. So Zenith for one, Quirion Ranger, then play Heritage Druid, then tap the three for three mana. Untap Reclamation Sage, replay my forest. Yeah, might do it. I can even get this Fintorn Elves onto the table. And then it's only Spell Pierce that gets me here. So that's going to be 15 plus 8, 23 trample damage against only 4 toughness. That should do it. So my sideboarding for the Delver matchup is usually minimal. I do like bringing in Progenitus in favor of one of these Crater Hoofs. And then I like to have a small number of Abrupt Decays because they can be okay against a flip Delver, but also just a hedge against something like Grim Lavamancer. So I try to make room for a double Abrupt Decay. Reclamation Sage can comfortably come out. And then I need one more cut. I do like all these draw card elves, so maybe just a Heritage Druid, because it's a little bit less of a combo racing type matchup and more of a every little mana counts type of a matchup. Thoughtseize is a consideration, but more like if I expected my opponent to have multiple board sweepers, I would bring in Thoughtseize so that they couldn't set one up as easily. But just in the dark, I think I'd rather have Abrupt Decay as my sort of flexible non-elves slot. Also, you know, fetching Bayou instead of Forest does come at a cost in this matchup. I like this hand to be a little better with a Quirion Ranger, because one landers always look a lot better with Quirion Ranger, but this is totally fine. The Bowmat again. Ah, there's Quirion Ranger. Okay, well, I'll start this game off the same way I started off last game. Okay, Delver, and there's the Lavamancer. That means I got to make a big play this turn. I have the tools if I'm not facing down a Daze or a Force of Will. So it seems like I want to start with Quirion Ranger, then play Heritage Druid Nettle Sentinel. Yeah. Just get a forest for now. Maybe I jumped the gun there. Perhaps I should have just, I mean, if I had three mana, I could have untapped the Llanowar Elves and just tried Natural Order for Progenitus. Normally, I wouldn't love a play like that in the face of Daze, but I think my opponent pressed F6 again. Something I should have at least considered, even if it's not the best play, put it that way. Now I'll go untap my Llanowar. Make three green. Untap my Llanowar again. Now I play the Visionary, which untaps Nettle Sentinel, then I can make four mana yet again and try the Natural Order. So I got to have my cake and eat it too. I think I'll sack the Quirion Ranger. Okay, so note that Craterhoof would not have been good enough there, but now Progenitus allows me to win the game even if my opponent has a board sweeper. So that is a turn two Progenitus. No Gaia's Cradle either. Okay, Delver reveals Brainstorm. So, I mean, my opponent has some racing power here with three in the air, two off the Grim Lavamancer, a couple of Lightning Bolts, but Progenitus is definitely going to be lethal in two turns. Okay, so two modes of collective brutality drain me for two and make me discard an instant or sorcery. That puts my opponent up to 20. Not a super relevant life total just yet. They may be looking to cash in the Bomat Courier this turn. And I'm not going to bounce my Visionary with the Symbiote. I'm going to see at minimum three fresh cards on my turn, and I think mana is more likely to be the limiting factor than finding a relevant card. I really want to put myself in a position where I can cast Natural Order or Craterhoof Behemoth if I find it. So just go ahead and untap. Nettle Sentinel. So let's begin with make three. Play Nettle Sentinel. Bounce Visionary. Play Visionary. So now mana should not be an issue anymore. I can even win with a Green Sun Zenith or a hard cast Craterhoof. But I do have to find it first. Okay. I'm gonna come in with everything in order to make sure my opponent can't buy a turn with a Collective Brutality. Maybe I'm shutting off Toxic Deluge too. Then my opponent's gonna Lavamancer me down to 10. Attack me down to 7, and we'll need to find two lightning bolts and a source of red mana, I guess. Yep, down to 10. So yeah, I think with the draw step and the three brainstorm cards, it has to be two bolts and a source of red mana, but no, that's too many cards. You have to put two back with Brainstorm, so I'm feeling pretty safe unless there's something that I've missed or some unexpected sideboard card coming my way. Okay. It's a cool trick. Brainstorm and respond by cracking the Bomat Courier. But now, with choked on red mana, I think it's over. And it is, so I advanced to 2-0. I'll see you for round 3. Hello, welcome back for match number 3 with Legacy Elves. I'm on the play this time. Gonna have to take a mulligan. This happens a fair amount with Elves because you only really have 14 lands that can produce mana on turn 1. Well, this has two copies of the best card in my deck in Glimpse of Nature, but not a lot of 1-mana creatures. And here you see the cost of playing a card like Reclamation Sage. Like, this hand would be a lot better if this was any creature that cost 1 mana. But pretty good scry to the top. Yeah, I'll top that, and I think my play is just Verdant Catacombs go. gonna have to play this in a pretty slow way. Like I might just draw my Quarian Ranger, then play Windswept Teeth and pass. if I'm against Storm or Sneaking Show, I might not get enough turns to play this the way I want to, but yep, gonna play Windswept Teeth and pass. Get two Arbors. Then if I go, then we'll see what I draw. All right, so my opponent waited, drew their cards, main phase Brainstorm. I am going to expect this to be Sneak and Show, I'd say. Okay, well, let's begin with Glimpse of Nature. There's Force Pitching Omniscience. I'm okay with that. Play another Glimpse of Nature. Is that what I want to do? Maybe I just attack for one, actually. Might as well grab Basic Forest. You never know when there could be a main deck Blood Moon. And I'll start with Glimpse of Nature again. Intuition, sure. Interesting. Okay. Well, at least I'm succeeding in, you know, effectively him to Turok-ing my combo opponent. Down to two cards in hand. Now I'll play Reclamation Sage. Take out the Lotus Petal if I can. And maybe I can just win by attacking for four a couple times. This is not how these games usually play out, but my opponent unable to assemble their combo, and it is remarkably hard to shut down Elves through normal means, but looks like I maybe spoke too soon. Here's the show and tell. I'll just put a Visionary into play. Whew, I can win. I can win. So we begin with Quarian Ranger. Tap a forest, untap the Arbor. replay forest. Natural order, sacrificing Dryad Arbor. Craterhoof Behemoth. Emrakul blocks the Behemoth, and it's still going to be 19 damage. Sweet. The Elvish Visionary is muddier than the Emrakul as a show-and-tell target. Okay, so winning game one is really nice because things get better for me after sideboard as I get to bring in these discard spells. It's still a pretty bad matchup. But things get at least a little bit better. I don't think I want the Reclamation Sage. Maybe if I had Pithing Needle, I could pair the Sage. I don't know. I think just trying to get a naked sneak attack is pretty ambitious. The game would have to play out in a fairly specific way for that to happen. So what else do I want to be cutting here? Definitely not the Birch Lore Rangers. Usually you have to tone it down on your combo a little bit if you're bringing in the six discard spells. I also expect Grafdigger's Cage. So potentially I want to cut down to like one natural order. Green Sun Zenith is probably too good. Oh, that's a reason to have Reclamation Sage if I expect Grafdigger's Cage. But now I got to cut more creatures. One Nettle, one Heritage. All right, let's try it. Perfect hand. Not only do I have black mana and a discard spell, but I also, could just win on the third turn with this hand. It's very nice. So even though my opponent could combo me on turn two, I think it would be incorrect to just guess on Cabal Therapy here. I think instead I should be looking at playing Fintorn Elves, or maybe even Green Sun Zenith is better. Yeah, I think I like Zenith for zero. Get it in before my opponent can play Grafdigger's Cage. Usually expect two cages in the sideboard of Sneak and Show, by the way. So that was end of turn, brainstorm, untap, ponder. Chooses to not shuffle. Interesting. Well, I mean, I could do some damage if I felt like the coast was clear. Go Glimpse, Quirion Ranger, untap the Dryad Arbor, Birchlore Rangers, Nettle Sentinel, play out my hand. Maybe I should just start that way. The key card to resolve this turn is the Quirion Ranger. But my opponent might just Force of Will the Glimpse, which would be amazing for me, given that I have a second one. I wonder if the coast is just clear. Huh. double nettle sentinel. Could we have a turn two win on our hands? Okay, so I think it's right to play the Bayou and play triple nettle sentinel, actually. Wonder what my opponent's thinking about now. If there's, I would have expected if my opponent had an interactive spell that I would have been cast already. Okay, but here's Force of Will for the Nettle Sentinel. So that is going to prevent me from actually comboing. Pitching Brainstorm. So now I'm gonna shift plans and make a black mana and cast Cabal Therapy. And I think I should just name Show and Tell. Got one. Now I get to... but two board sweepers. So we have a Petal, an Engineered Explosives, and a Pyroclasm. I guess I'll flashback and name the Pyroclasm, and then maybe I at least... The Explosives can't kill the Dryad Arbor. Huh. Thing. Okay, well, yeah, let's get the Show and Tell. And then I'll sack the Quirion Ranger and get the Pyroclasm. Although, maybe the Explosives is more deadly because it gets to stay on the board. I could just not flashback the therapy right now. Force my opponent to Pyroclasm. I bounce the Dryad Arbor. No, I don't like it. I'm going to sack the Quirion and name Pyroclasm. All right, so Engineered Explosives and Lotus Petal. Let's see if I can fight through them. Well, this is nice for me because it means if my opponent hadn't drawn Ponder, they would just put Engineered Explosives into play and leave it there, which would make it difficult for me to combo. But now they won't have enough mana for that, presumably. And my hand is so strong that I might be able to win next turn. It's a no shuffle. Huh. No shuffle, draw Scalding Tarn. I'm not sure what to make of that. Well, the coast is clear. I might get my board wiped afterwards, but for now, we're off to the races. So I have as much mana as I want. Just really got to draw into something helpful. Come on, we're looking for Green Sun Zenith, Crater Hoof Behemoth, Natural Order, Wirewood Symbiote, Elvish Visionary. But I'm striking out so far. One more draw. The game's going to get a lot harder if I don't win this turn, because now all my creatures die. So just play Dryad Arbor and pass. The good news is I have a Glimpse and a Cradle to rebuild if the top of my library is good to me. But my opponent did keep with the Ponder, so drew something helpful. I mean, maybe a Sneak Attack. All right, so now I decide how long I can afford to wait. My opponent drew one helpful card that they decide to keep with the Ponder. So, I mean, it feels like it could be half of the combo, maybe a Brainstorm, maybe a Pyroclasm. But either way, I think I'm going to make the judgment call to wait a turn, try to build up a better hand before I cast my Glimpse. Okay, now we're looking good. So let's start with Glimpse of Nature. Now I'll play Aquarian. Now a Cradle and a Birch Lore. Okay, looking good so far. Make 5 mana. Haven't used the Ranger yet, for the record. Huh. So, okay, it was a show and tell. Taking one away doesn't do all that much. I wish I had the Cabal Therapy still in the graveyard, but just gotta cross my fingers. I can win by attacking over the course of a couple turns here. Oh, you're kidding me. Wow. So I attack like this because I can bounce the one that gets blocked with Aquarian Ranger. So I take 1 down to 6. My opponent, I guess, will attack me, but then it's sort of a tough call whether or not to draw 7. It depends how many Pyroclasms and Engineered Explosives they have. Okay, if they brick, I can just attack for lethal. Ponder, no shuffle, that can't be a great sign for me. Ugh. This felt like one I was going to win. Also, three board sweepers in a matchup that's... Even without the board sweepers, this is a bad matchup, so I really have my work cut out for me in game three. Name Emrakul. The Aeon's Torn. Got one. All right, well, comical end to a pretty interesting game. So the main change that I'm looking to make is to cut my Reclamation Sage. If I'm going to have to fight through those board sweepers, I wonder if I want the Multani's Acolyte. Oh, I'll bring a second natural order, actually, because I didn't see Grafdigger's Cage. Yuck. Maybe if this was a Deathrite Shaman, this would be a keepable hand. But it's pretty iffy. Alright, so my first draw step, if it's a land that produces black mana, that's pretty good. If it's a creature, then I do set up for turn three natural order, but it would be a non-lethal natural order. Yeah, I think I have to throw this back. Better? Sure, it doesn't matter because I'm going to be fetching on turn one. Well, am I going to be fetching on turn one? Yeah, I mean, maybe I want to get Dryad Arbor at the end of the turn. That sounds good. This is a really, really, really hateful version of Sneak and Show to play against. So that turns off my natural order plan, but maybe Glimpse can still get the job done. Okay, well, bounce Visionary, untap the Arbor, play Quirion Ranger. That's nice because it can protect my Dryad Arbor in case my opponent has Pyroclasm. I'm developing kind of nicely, still have the Glimpse, which is going to be a must counter. And even if it does get countered, I have the Visionary Symbiote Engine. So my opponent's going to need, like, a fast combo with either a Board Sweeper or a Force of Will in order to beat me. Chooses to not shuffle. All right, Zenith can get Nettle Sentinel, Heritage Druid. We'll see what we need. But I think I'm going to start with make 3 mana Glimpse of Nature. Okay. Oh, this can't get anything in the face of the Grafdigger's Cage. That's bad news. That's Force Pitching Spell Pierce. All right, so then I'll use the 2 mana for Elvish Visionary. Perfect. So if I make 1 mana, untap this, recast the Visionary, then I can Thoughtseize. Alright, so I guess I just take away the Ponder, strand the Emrakul, and hope my opponent doesn't find Show and Tell. And it's tempting to take the Emrakul, but the fact that my opponent has all those Board Sweepers, I feel like they have a little more ability to control the game without comboing, so I think I would rather just try to fade rather than leave him with the Ponder. Also, I mean, Ponder's going to find half the combo at worst anyway, so. That was actually sloppy play. I hadn't made my land drop, so I should have bounced the Dryad Arbor to untap Quirion Ranger, then just replay Dryad Arbor and attack with the Ranger too. It's one extra damage. All right, so Ponder was the draw step. Let's see if it finds Show and Tell. chooses to not shuffle. So maybe it found sneak attack. All right, so we'll begin with Heritage Druid. Cast my... Oh, that was bad to make my land drop. I was thinking I was going to get a Dryad Arbor, but I can't with the Gravedigger's Cage. So I'll just fetch the trigger on the stack. That was another bad play. Should have tapped my cradle before I did that. Six down to four. Okay. Something to work with. All right, bunch of cards I can't cast in the face of that Gravedigger's Cage, but at least I'm developing a board. I want to stay above 15. That's pretty crucial here, so I should not fetch with that Windswept Youth if I could avoid it. Okay, so here comes Sneak Attack Emrakul. So I'm going to just try to keep Gaia's Cradle. All right, well, I'm definitely losing Bayou. My five weakest creatures. I feel like I want to keep a Symbiote and a Visionary. One, two, three, four, five, six. I go to one. Bottom top with the Preordain. Here's Ponder. Chooses two shuffle, so live to fight another day. Okay, I have seven cards that all don't do anything in my hand. This is pretty ugly. But it looks like my opponent's striking out as well. Huh. Good thing I found Findorn elves. Alright. Yeah, that's fine, I guess. Okay. So it looks like I begin with casting this visionary. Now attack for two, untap the Findorn Elf, play the visionary again. Oh no, probably gonna die. Shuffle. Oh no, they give me just enough hope that I can maybe come back. Oh man, what a match. All right, well, I'll be 2-1. I'll see you for round four. Hello, welcome back for match number four with Legacy Elves. Stumbled a little bit last round against Sneak and Show, but still with a 2-1 record. Ready to try for 4-1 in this league. I have to take a mulligan due to having no lands, and this hand is a lot better. So the way you normally play this one is turn one, Findorn Elves, turn two, make some mana, Zenith for a visionary, and then from there you've seen a handful of new cards and you can see what's developed. So I was on the play mulligan to six, my opponent mulligan to five and scryed to the bottom. I want to grab basic forest for starters. All right, Scalding Tarn for Volcanic Island could still be a number of different decks. Lightning Bolt. All right, so I'm going to put my opponent on probably some kind of Delver deck. So options this turn, I could play out all three of my elves. I could try to search for a Dryad Arbor. I'm not seeing that really getting me too much. I think I'll just play the Birch Lore and the Quirion and then play the other Quirion. Particularly against Delver, it's all about getting some traction in the early turns, because if they're in a position where you're doing one thing every turn and they can just answer it, then you never really get anywhere. But if you can flood the board a little bit, it becomes harder for them to use cards like Wasteland, Daze, Lightning Bolt to keep you down. Huh, Arid Mesa, not what I expected. Wow, okay. Dead Gone, I'm guessing, is just a hedge against Merit Liege. Okay, well, I still think it's pretty important to try to Zenith for a visionary here. It will mean not playing the Dryad Arbor, but what I can do is attack for two, make some mana, untap Aquarian. Okay. All right, well, my opponent didn't mulligan to five, so even though my draw is stagnating a little bit, maybe just attacking with some 1/1s will be enough to win. Well, as long as this is the plan, I'm just going to play out everything. Very unusual deck. Yeah, Visionary is down. All right. So Jace gonna Fate Seal me. So now an interesting question of, do I go after the Jace or do I go after my opponent? I think I have to go after the Jace. Okay. All right. So what I could do here, well, how much mana do I have? If I tap everything, that's 7 mana. Untap Arbor, replay Forest, 8, 9. So I could Zenith for Craterhoof. Even playing around Daze because of the Quirion Ranger, but not playing around Spell Pierce. Seems like it's probably worth it. So let's see, if my opponent just Force of Wills, my opponent just Force of Wills the Zenith, then I don't get to kill the Jace. And the game can go south from there. But if I just kill the Jace this turn, and then pass with good board presence and Greenstone Zenith in hand, and my opponent doesn't have many cards, I feel like that's a pretty good position for me. But if I'll lose an elf to the True Name and then potentially won't be able to Zenith for Craterhoof next turn. But I feel like there's no rush. My opponent is Brainstorm locked with the Jace. This is an interesting spot. I feel like I want to just send three creatures at Jace and the two Arbors at my opponent. And then trade off an elf for the Jace, and my opponent will probably be pretty stuck there, and I have a good hand. I think that's the play that allows the smallest number of things to potentially go wrong. Okay. That's fine. That's partially as expected. So unless that last one card is a spell pierce, I could have resolved Craterhoof Behemoth. But I think this is still likely to be a winning line. And now I can even just go ahead and grab an Elvish Visionary. Okay, well, Impulse is the scariest card here. My opponent has four lands. Force of Will is probably the second scariest card. Don't care hardly at all about Spell Pierce. But I don't really want to give the Spell Pierce and the Force of Will together. Interesting. Force of Will and Impulse are the cards that are scary, and then Lightning Bolt is whatever. Spell Pierce and Island aren't that good, but they are something, and they pair well with the Force of Will. Maybe Lightning Bolt and Force of Will against the rest, although I think it's pretty clear you want to take the... No, okay, this is fine. I don't mind this. I feel like my opponent will probably take the Impulse pile. Yeah, took the Impulse pile. There's the Island. So I have to remember about that Spell Pierce and not be careless. Alright, I guess just send the two Arbors to chip in for one damage. And there's some argument to not playing out the Nettle Sentinel in case of a board sweeper or if I draw a Glimpse of Nature. But I think, you know, given my opponent's very low and might play another Jace the Mind Sculptor, I want to just have a board presence. So there's the Impulse, as expected. So I could attack with just the Arbors, but if my opponent bolts the Ranger, then I lose two creatures. I could attack with everything, but that's only getting four damage at the expense of a creature, and it's pretty bad against Lightning Bolt. So I think I'll just pass with the Stalemate. Especially with the Glimpse now in hand. Sure. Guessing my opponent's going to cycle the Spell Pierce. So Spell Pierce gone. That is probably the best draw in my deck. So I'm going to start with Glimpse of Nature, put my opponent to the test here. Counterspell. Well, I hope my opponent doesn't have a Snapcaster. Okay. Now I can attack. Wow. Well, that game would have been a lot easier if I had just gone for the green Sinzenith for 8 on that one turn, but slow and steady wins the race in that particular case because my opponent couldn't find another Jace. Wow, that was like a poem. But yeah, my opponent didn't find a Jace or a Snapcaster Mage or anything to really put the game away, so I was able to just chip in for the last few points of damage. Don't forget my opponent mulliganed to 5 that game, and it's pre-board where control decks not as likely to have board sweepers, but things might get a little more challenging after sideboarding. I usually like to bring in Thoughtseize, but not Cabal Therapy in a matchup like this. Maybe not even bring in all 4 Thoughtseizes. And then Progenitus is very bad against the white control decks, but it looks like it might be pretty strong here. So these are the cards that I'm considering. Definitely going to cut 1 Craterhoof. Don't think the Reclamation Sage is going to be necessary. Then maybe cut 1 Natural Order. Maybe 3 Thought Seizes is enough. And then like a Heritage Druid. Okay, can work with this. Sometimes I cut a Gaia's Cradle against control decks down to 3. I like this hand. Yuck. Well, my opponent could easily have Brainstorm, but I think I'm just gonna open on Thoughtseize. So we have Island, Strand, Bolt, Dead Gone, a Braid, Force of Will. It's a lot of removal. I guess I'll just take a Lightning Bolt based on the texture of my hand. Decent draw. I'm gonna cast it. Just going to pay the echo, no need to rush with the way my hand is set up and the way my opponent's hand is set up. Is this going to be Vendilion Click? Snapcaster. So still Dead Gone, Abrade, and Force of Will as known cards in hand. I think I'd like to wait one more turn on that Glimpse of Nature if I can. So let's say I... Yeah, Zenith for Visionary looks like my best play. Alright, now we're set up well. I'm liking this. So Force of Will and two fresh cards in hand for my opponent. I'm just going to pay for that. I'm happy taking the maximum value patience route here. So my opponent with a Force of Will and an unknown card in hand. Getting to the point where I'm tempted to just block. Yeah, I think I'll just block. Guess I'll just wait till my opponent has to tap mana for something and then... Or until I have two must-answer cards. My opponent's only card is Force of Will. Brainstorm. All right, so this could be my opportunity. Fact or fiction in response. So I guess I'm going to put the two brainstorms. Well, the question is, do I want my opponent to be left with a brainstorm or a bolt? Probably a bolt. So if I split them like this, my opponent will take, I'm guessing, the brainstorm bolt pile, force the glimpse, and then it'll be lightning bolt against these four creatures. Okay, so I'm just going to play out my hand. I guess technically I should have tapped the Birch Lore for mana and left my Fetchland uncracked, because I don't have any Dryad Arbors left, but my opponent might not be aware of that. Sure. Hello. So, 6 mana. Yeah, I'm not seeing any way I can get to 9. But this is good, just assembling the symbiote visionary combo. Or not. So I don't have any fetchable lands left in my deck, but I guess I'll play this just for the heck of it. Yep. Going to be a close game. Alright, so that stops my chip away with one or two creatures plan. Now I have to draw something. Let's see. One. Two glimpses gone. Two still in the deck. I guess I'll hold this. Also, untapping the Nettle Sentinel is not trivial. Man, bad draws in these board stall situations. I feel like I'm probably going to lose this one. Okay, my opponent going aggressive now. I think it's going to be Snapcaster against everything. I'm pretty much resigned to losing this game and having to win game three with a fairly shortened amount of time on my clock, so I'm just kind of trying to play fast. It's probably going to be Bolt Me. Fire me, and then True Name does the job. Okay, I think I'd like to bring in another Thoughtseize and cut a Nettle Sentinel. I can work with this. Let's go with the turn one Thoughtseize. Maybe I can strip away a key Brainstorm, or at least not allow my opponent to hide something with Brainstorm. Four lands, Bolt, Dead Gone, True Name. I'll take the True Name. Oh no, not fire. Okay. I thought it was going to be fire ice, and that was going to be real sad for me. I should have cut a guy's cradle. I for sure should have done that. Kept one more one mana elf. All right, let's do it. Still a bit away from casting this Progenitus. My best draws are still going to be Green Sun Zenith and Elvish Visionary. Jeez, that's a hard card to beat, Weaver of Lightning. So I definitely can't put this in the same pile as these two. Maybe Weaver of Lightning and Pithing Needle against the rest. Yep, this is going to go badly for me. this point, it's time to see one more draw step, and then I'm willing to give this one to my opponent. Huh. All right, the game continues. It's just three lands and a Pithing Needle in hand. So I can't even Zenith for two yet. Need to draw another regular land, non-cradle land. Maybe they'll take my Progenitus. All right, that's good enough for me. Well, it'll be 2-2 going into round number 5. Hello, I'm back for the fifth and final match of today's Legacy League with Elves. On the draw with a fine hand. Not an exciting hand, but a decent one. Okay, looks like my opponent's playing Death and Taxes, which is one of the best matchups for Elves. But, you know, if my opponent's on the play with a good draw and I miss my second land drop, this is definitely not a foregone conclusion. Quarian Ranger was a good draw there. Anytime you're stuck missing land drops, this card generates you a lot of extra mana. Okay, well, that's pretty bad for me. Should be a really good time to draw a land. Okay. Did it. And I'm not interested in attacking into a possible Thalia here, so I'm just going to pass the turn. Okay. Canonist. This will be the first time in the league that I'm really happy to have a main deck Reclamation Sage. Sanctum Prelate. So this stops non-creature spells with the chosen mana cost. So it's going to stop my natural order. But I should be able to have a pretty explosive turn here. So I can start by Reclamation Saging the Canonist and then play out basically the rest of my hand. Though I cannot cast natural order. So if I wanted to, I could bounce the Sage and kill the Vial, but I think I'd rather just draw an extra card here since there are plenty of draws that would allow me to just win this turn. That's one of them. So we'll keep making mana. Then eventually Zenith for a Crater Hoof. X is going to be 8. I think I over-tapped, but whatever. So you can see how even after a bad start, sometimes you can fight through. I mean, it was pretty fortunate that I had the Reclamation Sage ready for the Canonist. But that worked out well. And then my sideboarding this matchup, 3 Abrupt Decays and a Progenitus. Cut a Crater Hoof, a Natural Order. And I actually used to trim the Deathrite Shamans this matchup because sometimes they could Phyrexian Revoker them. But can cut a Green Sun Zenith since they sometimes have Graft Digger's Cage, Containment Priest, even Thalia is decent against it. What else? Nettle Sentinel is okay because it is slightly harder to kill with Umezawa's Jitte. Alright, how about we trim one Zenith and one Heritage Druid? Maybe Heritage Druid's good. One Findhorn Elf. But yeah, Death and Taxes is was a big winner from the banning of Deathrite Shaman, and it's a very favorable matchup for Elves, so this is one good reason to choose Elves is, you know, that at least one popular deck that you're really happy to be paired against. But like I said, I've lost to Death and Taxes before. If they have a good draw on the play, there are certainly no guarantees. I think I'm just going to set up to try to Abrupt Decay that Vial. See exactly what my opponent does. Or Abrupt Decay something. You know, maybe a disruptive creature is more important to kill. Alright, well, yeah, I'm just going to grab a Bayou. Kill that Vial. I think I'll just see my draw step first anyway. No, I didn't mean to auto-yield to the Vial trigger. Okay, that's better. Canonist. Well, that's actually a bit annoying. Canonist shuts down my glimpses, and my opponents started finding their land drops, so, whew, the game that I thought was going to be relatively easy now is becoming pretty challenging. So I can do the Fog the Jitte trick with, you know, say my opponent equips a ground creature and attacks with the Jitte, I can block with Visionary and bounce it via Wirewood Symbiote. So I will bounce my Visionary in response to that. Okay, well, Natural Order can still do a number. I don't have another Crater Hoof Behemoth in my deck, but I can grab Progenitus, which is pretty good against Jitte and, you know, just in general when the game's slowing down a bit. So I could double block with these two, but I think would that be a good play to double block? Sure. Double block. then if my opponent kills my two arbors, I need to draw a land. And I still think Progenitus will win from this board if I can get him into play. Oh, God. Now I just have to do nothing until I can destroy the Jitte with Abrupt Decay or Reclamation Sage. Or I guess if I find a fifth land, I could go Elf Natural Order without passing priority, but the problem is I now have both of my Natural Order targets in my hand. Alright, I think I'm just going to concede to Cataclysm here. Was happy enough with my sideboarding. Progenitus would have been really good in that game if I had found my land on that one crucial turn. So yeah, let's try this for the final game of the match, final game of the league, final game of the video. Hope it goes well. All right. Good matchup, on the play, good 7-card hand. Can't go too wrong here, hopefully. Open on Bayou, Llanowar Elves. Okay, very nice start. Got the decay for whatever my opponent plays this turn. Have the Visionary Symbiote engine going. So I'm going to start with Abrupt Decay. Followed up with Elvish Visionary. Bounce it to untap Llanowar Elves. Now I could Zenith for an arbor, but I don't think that's necessary at this point. I'd rather save it for Reclamation Sage if I need to kill another Canonist, for example. Okay, Heritage Druid's a nice one here. I can draw three off the Visionary, so there's even some consideration to Zenith for Nettle Sentinel, which will generate me a lot of mana. Yeah, I think I like that. find Nettle Sentinel. Heritage Druid. Now make three. Play Visionary. Yeah. I think I'll just cast this. Now I do have to worry a little bit about Cataclysm. I think I want at least one Ranger in play, and I'll keep the other in hand. Maybe I should have played both Quarian Rangers. Cataclysm still hurts me pretty badly here. Okay, thankfully my opponent does not have it. End step, let's bounce a Visionary. Search for a Dryad Arbor. Now I need to find a way to Zenith for a Crater Hoof. Feels like I should be able to accomplish that. My opponent could have a Containment Priest, but I guess that's sort of going to get me either way. No Containment Priest, so is this going to be good enough? Yep. Alright, so a respectable 3-2 finish with Elves. I did feel like I got a little unlucky in that match against Sneak and Show. Unlucky in the sense that from particular points in the game, I was a favorite, but it is a bad matchup, so it's not unlucky to get paired against Sneak and Show and lose the match. So make of that what you will. But, you know, Elf still feels like a pretty strong deck. You have a couple really good matchups out there. You can sideboard to beat some of your weaker matchups, and it's still a powerful deck. So if you liked the video, remember you can always subscribe by clicking the link down below. And if you have particular decks, formats, types of videos you want me to make, be sure to, mention it in the comments or contact me on Twitter. I'm at Reid Duke, and I'm listening.